Today we will do chapter direct and inverse proportion. This chapter is in class 8th. Okay, and the book is NCERT book. So let's start. In this chapter we will talk about what is direct proportion, what is inverse proportion, and we will study method to solve direct and inverse proportion. So this is the tabular method. So let's start. Our first task is to understand the meaning of what is the direct proportion and inverse proportion. Sometime inverse proportion is also known as indirect. So both are same thing. So let's start with the meaning. A direct proportion, two quantities are said to be in direct proportion. If I increase one quantity, second quantity will also increase. If I decrease one quantity, second quantity also decrease. It means, let me give an example. In a car, I have a car. In a car, if I pour more petrol, more distance it will cover, right? But in a car, if I add less petrol, then it will cover less distance. So this is an example of direct proportion. Let me take one more. So we are purchasing potato and rate is fixed. Let me say fixed rate. If I increase the quantity and if I go for the money, if I increase the quantity instead of 2 kg, if I purchase 10 kg, I have to pay more. If I have to decrease the quantity, for example, only 2 kg I want, I have to pay less. Mean on increasing one quantity, second also increase. On decreasing first, second also decrease. So this is an example of direct proportion. So there are many more. When we will draw a graph of direct proportion, for example, here I will write distance. Or here I will write petrol in the car, it will always be a straight line. The graph will always be a straight line. So if two quantities are said to be in direct proportion, if X or Y directly proportional to Y. So this is proportion sign. Okay. And I can write in this way, X upon Y is equal to K constant. But we know the meaning of direct. Let's go for the meaning of inverse proportion. Two quantities are said to be in inverse proportion. If I increase in first, the second quantity will decrease. Okay, vice versa. If I decrease first quantity, second quantity will increase. Let me go how. In a construction job, for example, we are constructing a wall, right? If I increase number of person, number of worker, time taken will be less. So if I increase first, second is decreasing. So it is an example of inverse proportion. Let me take one more. So between school and home, 10 kilometer distance is there. If I increase the speed of the car, the time taken will be less. It means speed and time both are inverse proportion. How will you write? We will write speed inversely proportional is written in this way. Okay. Now, other way, if I decrease the speed, so this is a speed part. If I decrease the speed, I think time taken will be increased. So I hope this is the representative of inverse proportion. Now the question is, what about a graph of inverse proportion? If I will draw the graph of inverse proportion, that will never be a straight line. That will be appear like this. On increasing first, second will decrease. So this is a graph. More of about graph we will study in the chapter graph, introduction to graph. So now we are clear with what is direct or inverse proportion. Let's go for the next one now. Our next task is, what are the method to solve inverse and direct proportion? Method to solve direct and inverse. Okay, there are two methods we will study in this chapter. One is unitary method, you have already done in lower classes, and one is tabular method. This is my favorite, and this I will say important one. So this is time saving also. Let me take one example. So both method I will do. Machine soaked 840 bottle in 6 hours. How many bottles? So bottle I have to find. So I'm doing by unitary method. What unitary method said, here I have to find bottles in 5 hours. I will write in 6 hour, number of bottles will be 840. I will find 1 hour. It will be 840 divided by 6. Now my question is to find in 5 hours. So here I will write 5 hours and number of bottle will be 840 divided by 6 into 5. So this I will simplify. So let me go for answer. 6 vanja. This is 140 and answer is 700. But what about tabular method? So this is interesting one. The first step is to construct a table, right? Here it is written number of bottles. So here I will write number of bottles. Okay. And here I will write time. So 840 bottle, for 840, 6 hours are required. Now question is find, whatever we have to find, we generally take X. So in 5 hours, how many bottle we have? The first question arises here, is it direct or inverse? It is an example of direct. In direct, what we used to do, we divide 840 divided by 6. These two I will divide. Let me explain how. If it is a direct, so these two quantity I will write in division, and these two quantity I will write in division, x upon 5. Okay, now I will cross multiply. On cross multiplication, this number will be go here on transposition. So 840 multiplied by 5 is 6 is equal to x. I think this is the same, and our answer will be x value is 700. So the best part of this method is we no need to find 1 hour. Okay, we can straight away find the answer. So in this chapter, we will more stress on tabular method. So now question is, what about in inverse proportion? Let me take one more example. So here is the case, how to solve direct proportion question or inverse proportion question by tabular method. Let me take one example. Cost of 5 meter cloth is given. It is 100 rupees. So first step is to construct, right, draw this table. We have to find 7 meter cloth. So whatever we have to find, I generally take X. First step is to check whether is it direct or inverse. More cloth I required, more money I have to pay. Mean on increasing first, second is also increasing. It means it is a example of direct. Here I will write direct. What we do in direct? In direct, we will write upon D for direct, D for divide. I hope this way to remember. So I will write 5 divided by 100 and 7 upon X. So on cross multiplication. On cross multiplication, what I will do, I will multiply 5 into x, that is 5x, or I will multiply 100 into 7, that is 100 into 7. So my x, I will find out 100 into 7 divided by 5. So it is 20 into 7, that is 140. So I hope in direct, what we do, divide. But what about in case of inverse proportion? Let's go for the 6 pipe are required. To fill, there is a tank. Okay, in this tank 6 pipe are required to fill a tank in 80 minutes. First is to draw table, 6 pipe and 80 minutes. Now how many, what is the time, how long mean time if 5 pipe of same? So question is find that time. Now you all agree with me, if I increase number of pipe, if I increase pipe, I think time taken will be decrease. So on increasing first quantity, second quantity is decreasing. It means it is an example of indirect or inverse. Okay. So what we do in inverse? In inverse, we will not divide. Inverse, we will multiply. I will multiply 6 into 80. So these two will be multiply in case of inverse. Right. Here I will write, I will multiply these two also. 5 into x. So my question is to find x here. So 5 I will send on the transposition, 6 divided by 80, and this is 5. 5 ones are 5 ones are 3 and 30, and this is 16, 6 are, this is 96. I hope you understand the difference. One difference you find is, in case of direct, you have to divide, right? So this is a division. In case of inverse, you have to multiply up and down. So this is a difference in case of inverse proportion, in case of direct proportion. So let's go for the question answer now. Our first question is, which of the following car charges are near a station? Check whether this is in direct proportion or not. We have to check. So first is, let me find a ratio. I will find whether ratio is correct. So 4R, it is 60. I will take rupees. Here I will write rupees divide by time. Okay, so 60 divided by 4, it is 4 ones of 4 to 15. So our first answer ratio is this one. Let's go for the second one. Second one is 100 divided by 8, but this is not equal to 15. Okay, it means this also, if I go 140 divided by 12, this is also not coming 15. It means this is in no, it is not an example of direct proportion. So how I reach my answer? Because when I find the ratio of every step is coming different. So now our task is question number two. This is interesting one. In question two, the first step, it is given that for one part of red pigment, 8 base part required. Right? Now the question is, find the part of base that need to be added in case of 4 or 7. I hope first question arises, is it an example of direct or inverse? See, I will write here what it is, an example of direct. Now the question is, how I decide is it direct? If you want to go for more paint, it is talking about more paint. Paint is foaming. More paint, if we want to foam, I think more amount, more liter of base we required. So direct. So in case of direct, what we do here, there are many parts. First part is find is take these two. Okay. So it is 1 by 8 equal to 4 by A. Okay. Cross multiplication. On cross multiplication, 1 into A. This is 1 into A is equal to 8 into 4. What is the answer of A? It is 32. So this is our first answer. Now, what about in case of second one? We will take now the first and the seventh one. These two I will take. Mean our second part will be 1 by 8 is equal to 7 by. This is our second part. Now our third part will be 1 by 8 is equal to 12 by C. Right, now our fourth part will be 1 by 8 equal to 20 by D. So I hope remaining part we will do. So we will find B here, so C and D. So this is a question number 2. In question 3, this is related to question 2. Let me do what is this question all about. If one part of red pigment, it is given red pigment ka one part ke liye 75 ml paint is required. Question is, for this much of base, how many red pigment? I think you agree with me, this is an example of direct. So how to solve direct? 1 upon 75 is equal to x upon 1800. I think next step is on cross multiplication. So you will do your own. Let me do classwork. Let's go for the next one. So this is interesting one. This we have already done. A machine of first thing is to construct table. This table is important. Now more bottles, more time. How many bottle will be manufactured in filled in 5 hours? If I talk about time and bottles, if more time is given, more bottle will be filled. If less time is given, less bottle is filled. It means it is example of direct. First thing you have to write direct. In direct, what we do? Divide 840 divided by 6 and x divided by 5. So I hope after that x we have to find. Here I will write on cross multiplication. So what I will do, 6 into x I will write here, and 840 into 5 I will write. So my first step is to, on transposition, 6 will come here, 840 multiplied, and calculation part I am leaving to you. So let's go for the next one. So this is a question number 5. What is the question? On zooming the photograph of a bacteria, if it is enlarged 50,000 times, it attain a length of 5 cm. 50,000 times zoom kiya, 5 cm length. Question is, find the actual, what is the actual length? It mean without zoom. So here write, number of zoom is, this is for without zoom. So without zooming, we are fine. This, if it is 1, we have to find the length. Second part is, if it is 20,000 time, it is, then also we have to find the length. So there are two parts. So let me simplify. Our first part is, whether it is a direct or indirect. So first question is, so you all agree with me, if I increase zooming, zoom part I increase, I think length will also increase. If I decrease zoom, length will also decrease. It means it is an example of direct. So in direct, what we do, we generally divide D and D, both start with. So 50,000 divided by 5 is equal to 20,000 divided by x. So on cross multiplication, so here I do cross multiplication, this multiply with the x, so it will become 50,000 multiply x, 20,000 multiply by 5. Here I will write 5. So I only have to find x, so x on the left side, so it is 20,000 multiply by 5, and 50,000 is in denominator. So these 4 zero I will cancel with this, and 5 say 5, 2 centimeter is the answer. So what about the second part? In second part, I will take these two. What I will do, 50,000 divided by 5 is equal to 1 by y. I hope you will do this. This is your classwork. Let's go for the next one. Our next question is question number 6. In a model of SIP, so once it is a model, this is a table which I can draw. In model, if 9 centimeter is the height, in actual it is 12 meter. It means if it is a model and it is actual, in model if more is of length, in actual also more of length. In model if smaller thing, in actual it will be smaller. It means it is an example of direct. Question is, find the length of the SIP. This length I have to find out. Okay, so direct mein what we do, we divide. How we divide? 9 divided by 12 is equal to x by 28. I hope now you will do on cross multiplication. Cross multiplication. So I'm leaving this up to you. Let's go for the next one. Our next question is, suppose 2 kg of sugar contain, we are giving weight. In that 2 kg, 9 into 10 ki power 6 number of crystal. Crystal mean small pieces, dane. That is a crystal. Question is, in 5 kg, how many? This is our first part. And in 1.5 kg, how many? So this is our second part. So there are two parts in this question. So first thing arises, whether it is a direct or inverse. Well, there is more quantity. In what way? If more is the quantity, I think more crystal will be there. So it means less quantity, it means less crystal. It is an example of direct. So this is our first step. So what do in direct? In direct, we generally divide. So how we'll divide? Here I will write 2, 9 into 10 k power 6. These two I'm finding. 5 upon x. So on cross multiplication, this 2 into x equal to, so 5 into 9 multiply 10 k power 6. So this is x will be 45 into 10 k power 6 divided by 2. So if I write 45 into 10 or multiply 10 k power 5, so this I reduce here 5, or here it is 10. it is divided by 2. So 2 ones are 2 fives are. So our answer is 5 fives are 25, 2 to 5 into 10 ki power 5. So this is our answer number of crystal. Let's go for the next one. In the same in this case, here now I will take these two. This I will take with this. How will I take? 2 upon 9 into 10 k power 6 and 1.2 into y. I hope it is an example of direct. So on cross multiplication. On cross multiplication. So this part I'm leaving up to you. You will do your own. So let's go for the next. This is our question number 9. So this question says, if height is 5 meter 60 centimeter, the shadow will be of 3 meter. Change into centimeter. Change in centimeter. So it will become 560 centimeter. How? In 1 meter, 100 centimeter are there. This will change into 320 centimeter. This will change into 1050 centimeter. Okay, this will change into 500 centimeter. Now let's back to the question. Question is, if this is the height, this is a shadow. If this is the height, we have to find the shadow. So I hope you overview more height. If I talk about more height, I think more shadow, right? If less height, it means less shadow. It is an example of direct, right? So let's say both two part. First part is these two I will simplify. Divide 560 divided by 320 is equal to 1050 divided by x. I hope now you will do. So in second part, what I will do, I will make pair with this. Mean 560 divided by 320 is equal to y upon 500. So it is given 5 meters. So I change into centimeter. I hope this again you will do on cross multiplication. So let's go for the next one. So this is the last question of our exercise. First, a load truck travels 14 kilometers in this one, right? It is a distance and it is a time. Okay. If the speed remains same, please make sure speed is same. How far in 5 hours? 5 hours, if this is in minute, first thing I did, it changed into minutes. Okay. Now we all know more distance. I hope you will agree with me. More time. It means it is an example of direct. In direct, what we do? We will divide. So how will you do? 14 divided by 25 equal to x divided by 300. So next step is on cross multiplication. Okay, I hope you will do now your own. So now with this, our first exercise over. Let's go for the next exercise. Now in this exercise, I will talk about inverse proportion questions. So let's take about, let's discuss which of the following are in inverse proportion. Number of worker and time. If worker increase, less time, it means it is inverse. Okay, so let's talk about time taken for a journey and distance traveled in a uniform speed. Uniform speed, I think if more time, more distance. So it is not inverse, it is example of direct. Because speed is uniform. So we only thing is distance and time. These two are in direct proportion. Area cultivated by land and crop harvested. More area, more crop. Again, it is example of direct. Okay. Time taken, fixed journey and speed. See, if speed increase, I think time will decrease. So it is an example of inverse. So this is fourth. And population of a country and area of more population. If I increase my population increase, I think area of land per person decrease. So it is example of inverse. So let's see. So this is the question for us. What is the question? In a television game show, 1 lakh is the money that is divided into. If it is one winner, whole amount he will get. If there are two, 50,000 T's. It means money and participant. If participant in more participant or more winner, I will say instead of participant, I will add winner. Each will get less because prize money is fixed. So it is an example of inverse. So what do in inverse? This we have to find out for 45. In inverse, I will first will multiply these two. I will take these two. So I will multiply above and 2 into 50,000 is equal to 4 into x. So this is our first part. So only x I have to find. So 2 into 50,000 divided by 4. So this part x will be 4, 1 ja 4, 1, 2, 1 is left, 4, 2 ja 4, 5 ja. So this is 0, 0, 0, and this is the first. I think second part, it will be pair of this to these two. Mean 2 upon 50,000 or 5 upon, sorry, I'm right, I'm doing in a wrong way. So here I have, it is a inverse, so I have to multiply. So I will multiply 2 into 50,000 is equal to 5 into y. I have, now you will do, this is, so remaining part are classwork. Let's go for the next one. So this question is again interesting one. If number of, there are four, this is called spoke. If number of spoke increase, I think angle between these two decrease. It is 90 degree in case of 4. It is 60 degree. So it is increasing spokes. If I increase, angle between these way decrease. So this is the angle. So it is an example of inverse. The first thing is inverse. Question is, calculate the angle between when there are 15 spokes. So what I will do, this pairing I will do. 4 into 90 is equal to 15 multiplied by x. Right? So this is first part. So only thing x mujhe find karna hai. 15 ko I will send here. 4 into 90 or 15 se kya? 15 1 ja, 15 6 ja. So 24 is the answer. Okay, 24 spokes. Now for the second part. This I will multiply with this. 4 into 90 will be is equal to y into 40 degree. I hope now this part you will do your own. So in the inverse proportion, we have to multiply above and below. So let's go for the next one. So in this case, question is box of sweets among 24 children. Each will get 5 sweets. If in a class 24 children are there, 5 each will get. Question is, if the number of children is reduced by, see, reduced by 4 means decrease 4. If number of children are 20, how many each will get? How many would each get? So here one, we have students and we have laddus. Fix, laddus are fixed. More student, each student will get less. So it is an example of inverse proportion. So inverse may we multiply 20 and 20 into x. Please make sure it is 20, not 24. I hope this part now you will do. So let's go for the next one. Our next question is question number 5. So in this question, a farmer has enough food for 20 animals, right? 6 days ke liye. How would it last if 10 more? More mean addition. Here I will add. It become 30. So how number of days? See, if animal, now question is to decide direct. If more animal, the food will last less days. It means it is example of inverse. So inverse, we will multiply 20 into 6 is equal to 30 into x. I hope now you will do.